So in the time that I've been away from the podcast, really just a little over a month or so, I've actually been back home to Ohio. I got to see one of my good friends get married. It was a beautiful ceremony. Shout out to everybody who I got to see and speak to and catch up with. You all are rock stars. Speaking of rock stars, when I was home, I also got to see one of my favorite bands perform live, The Main Squeeze, at the Beachland Ballroom in Cleveland. Incredible show. I've got a video on the channel. You can check that out if you're into that kind of thing. But enough of the sentimental shit. Let's get right into it. What's going on, everybody? Good morning. You are tuned into another episode of the Black Man Into the Wild podcast. You know, I'm blessed to be here with you all today, and as always, I'm blessed to have you here with me as well. The Black Man Into the Wild podcast was born in the Pacific Northwest and covers topics centered around the most disruptive technological advancements that are going to play a role in reshaping our society for decades to come. Today, I want to introduce you all to a company called ESS, based in the Pacific Northwest. They've just received a major investment from Honeywell. And if you're not familiar with Honeywell, Honeywell is an American publicly traded multinational conglomerate headquartered in Charlotte, North Carolina. Some of the business sectors they primarily operate in include building technologies and aerospace. And as far as ESS, again, they are based in Wilsonville, Oregon, founded by a team with deep experience in fuel cells, electrochemistry, advanced material science, and renewable energy. The company began shipping turnkey energy storage solutions in 2015 that allow companies and municipalities to control their own energy future. With its safe, earth-abundant, all-iron flow battery technology, ESS is helping project developers, utilities, and EPCs make the transition to more flexible, non-lithium-ion long-duration storage that's better suited for the grid and the environment. Now, in the last episode, we talked about the growing number of electric vehicle battery factories being propped up around the country, so I thought that this story here about ESS would be a great one to follow up with. We're also going to be talking about Daimler Truck today on the podcast, as they have stepped up electric production in Portland with a new box-style delivery truck. The Freightliner EM2 is a box truck for pickup and delivery. It joins the heavy-duty E-Cascadia in Daimler's electric portfolio. If you didn't know, Cummins and PACCAR recently teamed up with Daimler Truck North America to make battery cells on Swan Island in Portland. But before we get started today, as always, if you have not already, please go ahead and subscribe to this channel, like the video, and share with your friends if you like what you hear. And as a reminder, you can listen and download each episode of the podcast on Spotify and Apple Podcasts. We're streaming right now on all major digital streaming platforms, including Amazon Audible and the iHeartRadio Podcast Network. It says here, Honeywell invests $27.5 million in ESS to advance iron flow battery storage. Honeywell has invested $27.5 million in long-duration energy storage provider ESS, an initial strategic equity investment that is part of a broader collaboration to advance the development and market adoption of iron flow battery energy storage. The deal comes as the energy sector experiences a growing interest in the role long-duration energy storage can play on the grid. ESS's iron flow battery chemistry can provide up to 12 hours of energy storage and doesn't use critical materials associated with lithium-ion batteries. It says here, Honeywell's $27.5 million dollar investment in energy storage systems, ESS marks a major stride in advancing long-duration energy storage. Under this agreement, Honeywell plans to procure $300 million worth of ESS products over 6 years, igniting fresh market opportunities. ESS will also gain control of Honeywell's flow battery-related intellectual property. This partnership leverages Honeywell's expertise in advanced materials and solutions to bolster ESS's long-duration energy storage technology. A report predicts that by 2040, long-duration energy storage could deploy 1.5 terawatts to 2.5 terawatts of power capacity globally, storing up to 10% of all electricity consumed, requiring an investment of $1.5 trillion to $3 trillion. Long-duration energy storage is pivotal for grid reliability and resilience, a gap not yet met by short-duration lithium-ion batteries. Honeywell recognizes its transformative impact on decarbonizing the grid. Collaboration between Honeywell and ESS extends to supply chains, aiming for accessible and stable iron flow battery supply chains. It says here, Honeywell's strengths in material science and power electronics enhance the supply chain's breadth and efficiency. The industry's growing recognition of long-duration energy storage's importance signifies its role in achieving global net zero goals. This partnership is not just an investment. It's a stride toward a sustainable energy future, accelerating decarbonization efforts across multiple sectors. Next, Daimler's electric island, first of its kind in the U.S., it says here, from its headquarters on North Portland's Swan Island, Daimler Truck North America has ambitious goals for moving the nation's freight. The next generation of electric vehicles is being developed right here. Its Freightliner and Western Star brands are manufactured in Portland and at several plants across the country, employing 3,000 workers in Portland and Southwest Washington alone. Freightliner was born 80 years ago in 1942. The former Consolidated Freightways started producing trucks in Northwest Portland and quickly became among the world's leading heavy vehicle manufacturers. From about 1965 to 2021, they built about 500,000 vehicles across both Freightliner and Western Star brands, said Jessica Landrum, a training supervisor for Daimler. Portland native Leland James founded the company in Salt Lake City and brought the truck manufacturing operation home. In 1981, Daimler acquired Freightliner, separate from its Mercedes-Benz brand. Nate Hill, who is helping to create an infrastructure for Daimler trucks and other electric vehicles, said, quote, Swan Island's electric island is really the first of its kind in the entire United States. Hill said that they stayed in Portland even though there were options to move elsewhere at different times. Now, in a recent press release, it says here, that Daimler Truck North America has started series production of battery electric Freightliner EM2. Daimler Truck North America, DTNA, is starting Freightliner EM2 series production at its manufacturing plant here in Portland, Oregon. The first production units will be delivered in the U.S. to Ferguson, Hogan Truck Leasing, Penske Truck, Pitt, Ohio, Ryder System, Titan Freight Systems, and Velocity Truck Rental and Leasing. They say here that the battery electric medium-duty truck is designed for pickup and delivery applications and represents one of now 10 battery electric vehicles from Daimler Truck in series production worldwide. Quote, the start of production for this versatile truck marks another important milestone on our journey to a zero-emissions product line, said Rakesh Aneja, head of e-mobility at DTNA. The feedback we've received reinforces our confidence that the Freightliner EM2 will meet and exceed our customers' expectations. Our partners and dealers are looking forward to introducing the Freightliner EM2 to their customers, and we're excited to see it in use by customers in their fleets. The EM2 features a proprietary, fully integrated battery electric Detroit e-powertrain. Its streamlined design places electric motors and a two-speed transmission directly on the drive axles, resulting in minimized energy cost per mile. The driving range varies based on the two available battery capacity options for the EM2. The Class 6 single motor model provides up to 190 continuous horsepower, a 194 kilowatt hour battery, and a typical range of 180 miles on a single charge. In contrast, the Class 7 dual-motor variant offers up to 255 continuous horsepower, supported by a 291 kilowatt-hour battery, providing a typical range of 250 miles on a single charge. With that being said, thanks for listening, everybody. This has been another episode of the Black Man Into the Wild podcast. Have a great day.